Well, after a couple weekends on the road, Centenary Baseball back in town as they begin a weekend set against a conference foe. Today, from Sheehy Stadium in Shreveport, Louisiana, the gents meet the Austin College Ruse. Good afternoon, everybody. Great to be with you again for another weekend of gents baseball. Pierre Bida alongside Preston Ludwig. And Preston, we were talking about it just a few minutes ago. The gents have to get the ball moving at some point this season, and this weekend seems like a good opportunity to do so.
Yeah, this weekend's a huge series for the gents. They came off a weekend split against Dallas last week, went 1-1. Third game got canceled due to weather, but they really need to come out here and get on a hot streak and take three from the Ruse today, and that'll set them up good for next week against Shriner on the road.
Both teams coming in with a 1-1 conference mark, and that was after the split last weekend, like you mentioned, against Dallas. And the guy who's getting the ball for the gents today, Cody Myers, how about his last time out? 13 strikeouts, tied for, I think, second best.
Second place, yeah.
In the D3 era in a single game. I mean, this left-hander seems to be coming into his own in his sophomore season. What can you say about him?
I mean, that's everything that you want from Cody Myers and pretty much anyone that comes in their sophomore year, you know. You came in, have a great first year. Now it's time to really step it up and keep working. It's a really young team, and they need younger guys to step up and be a leader. And Cody Myers showing it on the field so far this season, especially last week. That's the stuff that we need from every single player on the gents lineup.
He'll be opposed by Tristan Mallory for the Ruse, who come in with a 7-9 mark, half game better overall than the gents. Their lineup looks like this. Tino Ramirez leading off at second base, to be followed by the left fielder Tripp Toms, then the DH Rayshon Riley, followed by the cleanup hitting first baseman Drake Trapani. Then comes Brandon Hill, the center fielder, followed by the third baseman Asher Thompson. Mason Woodhouse bats seventh place short. He'll be followed by the catcher Greg Smith, and then the right fielder Ryan Padfield rounds things out for the Austin College Ruse. Their head coach Sean Counts, assisted by Justin Lambright. For the gents, who come into this one with a record of 6-9, they'll be leading off with Carson Livesay, the sophomore left fielder, followed by Lenny Forth getting the start at DH and batting second. Then the first baseman Alex Miller, followed by the cleanup hitting right fielder Austin Benoit. Joby Boone bats fifth and plays shortstop. Then comes the sixth hitting third baseman Clay Menard. Colin Pitts plays center field and bats seventh, followed by the catcher Jake Gauntz. And batting ninth at second base is Miles Keith. Mike Diaz, again, the head coach for the gents, assisted by Cody Crowder, Chris Zapata, and Tyler Welch. And we got a good ball game coming up in about 15 minutes. You're speaking a few minutes ago, Preston, about how this is a must-win series for the gents. I mean, if they wanted a ticket back to Cleburne in about a month and a half, they got to get things going. I mean, it was a good to great last weekend against Dallas. I mean, I know who knows what would have happened in that third game, but I mean, Cody Myers striking out 13 and then, you know, dropping the second game. They just got to get stuff going.
Yeah, I think the big story is going to be pitching in this series. You know, you got Cody Myers coming off a great week last week against Dallas, and then you have Herrera most likely going game two today. Those are two guys that have to go out there and throw strikes consistently, get ahead of batters, and get outs early. I know Cody Myers threw a lot of pitches in last week's game against Dallas in the triple digits range. I think a lot of his at-bats were full count at-bats. Not putting away guys early. I think that's what the gents need right now. Put guys away early, save the arm, just in case, you know, you need to come back tomorrow and maybe throw an inning or two. And then, obviously, there's got to be some bear down for the guys coming out of the pen this week, especially in Game 3, with the potential to possibly staff that entire game. It's going to come down to those younger guys and if they're going to step up to the occasion.
Well, the last time the gents hosted the Ruse was in April of 2022. It was a three-game sweep the gents got. And the last game they played, the third and final game, April 15th, do you know who was the starting pitcher for that finale against the Ruse a couple years ago?
I don't believe it was myself.
It was you.
It was?
It was
okay.
You pitched seven shutout innings, struck out six, got the win. So the last time the Ruse played here, you were on the mound, and now you're up here doing some color commentary in the booth.
Pretty crazy how the tables turn.
Yeah, just less than 2 years have gone by, and then, yeah, here we are. So got a great couple games coming your way today from Sheehy Stadium. It's the Ruse and the Gents coming your way next.
and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to GD Stadium for today's conference doubleheader matchup between the Austin College Rouge and your Centenary Jets. Here today, starting lineups first for the visiting Rouge, leading off and playing second base, number 17, Tino Ramirez. Batting second and playing left field, number 12, Chris Toms. Batting third, the designated hitter, number 18, Rayshon Riley. Batting fourth and playing first base, number 20, Jake Trapani. Batting fifth and playing center field, number 10, Brandon Hill. Batting sixth and playing third base, number 14, Asher Thompson. Batting seventh and playing shortstop, number 2, Mason Woodhouse. Batting eighth and catching, number 29, Greg Smith. Batting ninth and playing left field, number 8, Ryan Matthews. Tristan Mallory. Austin College is coached by Sean Pounce. He is assisted by Justin Lambert. The Southern Georgia Athletic Conference and the NCAA promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. Profanity, racial, or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives. Including signing out anyone by name, number, or position, as grounds for removal from the set of competition and other disciplinary action. Public intoxication, as well as the consumption or possession of alcoholic beverages and/or tobacco products, is strictly prohibited. Persons throwing objects or participating in other acts in conflict with good sportsmanship and fair play are subject to ejection. Thank you for your cooperation in supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Just a reminder, fans, concessions, programs, and restrooms are located at Virginia Place down the right field line. Thank you.
starting lineup for your Centenary Band. Leading off and playing left field, a sophomore from Lafayette, Louisiana, number 27, Carson Livesey. Batting second, designated hitter, a sophomore from Flowerbound, Kansas, number 29, Lenny Gore. Batting third and playing first base, a freshman from Cypress, Texas, number 40, Alex Miller. Batting fourth and playing right field, a senior from Wealth, Louisiana, number 12, Austin Benoit. Batting fifth and playing shortstop, a senior from Opelousas, Louisiana, number 2, Trophy Boo. Sixth and playing third base, a sophomore from Berwick, Louisiana, number 6, Clay Menard. Batting seventh and playing center field, a sophomore from Lexington, Texas, number 25, Colin Hicks. Batting eighth and catching, a senior from Katy, Texas, number 24, Jake Don. Batting ninth and playing second base, a freshman from Lindale, Texas, number 31, Miles Key. And the starting pitcher, a sophomore from Brentwood, Texas, number 4, Cody Meyer. Centenary is coached by Mike Diaz. He is assisted by Cody Crowder, Chris Zapata, and Tyler Wells. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Cody Myers takes the hill for the Gents. The left-hander winds and deals the first pitch. It's a fastball that rides too far upstairs. 1-0 on Tino Ramirez, who's DHing and leading off for the Ruse. 2:32, first pitch. And Myers winds and deals another fastball and another ball. Two balls and no strikes on Ramirez. 66 degrees and sunny here in northwest Louisiana. 2-0 from Myers finds the zone, and it's 2-1 now. Ramirez, Toms, and Riley do up for Austin College. First home game for the Gents in a couple weeks. 2-1. Another fastball, another called strike, and Myers evens up the count at 2-2. Myers coming into this one with a 4-1 record. ERA under 1, it's at .99. As of now, he winds and deals the 2-2. Swing and a miss. Strikeout number one for Myers, and that's how this one gets underway.
Batting second. Second baseman, number 12, Tripp Toms.
So in steps the second baseman, Tripp Toms. Strikeout number 28 for Myers as Toms lines that one into pretty deep left center field, giving chase Livesay and Pitts. And it's Livesay approaching the track who reaches out and makes the one-handed grab for out number two. So with two down, that brings up the left-handed hitting right fielder, Rayshon Riley. Against the lefty Myers, who throws a strike in there right down the middle. Nothing and one.
Other than the leadoff batter, so far Myers has found the count early. Found the zone early and gotten ahead of the Ruse lineup.
Riley chops that one foul, and Myers ahead in the count, nothing and two. Crowd still filing in here to Sheehy Stadium on a Saturday afternoon. We thank you for spending part of your Saturday with us, wherever you might be. Nothing in two, here it is. Fastball up high.
I'm going to assume there's going to be a lot of dogs at the park today, as it is Pups at the Park Day.
That's right, I saw that. Pretty cool they got that going on. One, two. Reaches out and pokes it foul. And we'll do it again. One, two. Fastball just misses low. Could have been a strike, but wasn't. And the count evens at two.
That was a good two-strike pitch.
Deuces wild. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The pitch from Myers. Another foul ball.
Rayshon Riley so far in the year, 61 at-bats, only two strikeouts. So he does put the bat on the ball.
Gents infield shifted a bit to the right. That fastball just misses outside. Myers getting squeezed a little bit here, and the count runs full. Jake Trapani waits on deck. He'd hit next should the inning continue. The payoff pitch from Myers. Here it is. Fights off a slow curveball and sends it foul.
Pitch number nine about to be on the way. Another long at-bat, like I mentioned earlier before this one went underway.
Something's got to give. Another payoff pitch. up the middle. The shortstop Boone behind the second base back fields and throws on to first. And it's a 1-2-3 first inning for Cody Myers after the top half. It's the Ruse nothing Gents coming to bat. Welcome back to Sheehy Stadium. Last of the first coming up. Nothing ball game, and it's Carson Livesay set to lead off for the Gents against Ruse left-hander Tristan Mallory. Livesay fourth and Miller, top third of the Gents lineup. Lefty against lefty to open the inning. First pitch. Fastball that just misses wide, 1-0.
Home plate umpire so far in this one, not giving anyone that outside corner.
Late swing and a foul off to the left, heads up. A trio of Gents bringing some bases, some backup bases from the clubhouse, almost got their heads taken off. Fastball outside. Livesay, a sophomore out of Lafayette, in his second season with the Gents. The wind in the 2-1, slashed foul. Livesay batting at a 379 clip coming in. Leaves that fastball up high, and the count moves to 3-2. Payoff pitch. Outside, ball four. And the Gents have their leadoff runner aboard to get things going. Throw over to first, and Livesay is back standing. Lenny Forth, the DH, standing in. The Flower Mound native hitting 282. The runner goes. Pitch is taken for a strike, and the catcher, Smith, unable to get control of the ball. So it's a stolen base for Livesay. Livesay's 10th stolen base of the season. Swing and a foul tip into the mid of the catcher for strike two. O-2, fastball up and away.
Lenny so far this year, 39 at-bats, 11 hits, 5 RBI on the year. Only batting 282, looking to improve in this weekend series.
Runner goes. Pitch is swung on and grounded to the right side. On a couple of hops, the first baseman Trapani fields and steps on the first base bag. Fourth grounds out for out number one, but on the play, Livesay takes third.
Batting third, first baseman, number 40, Alex Miller.
First pitch to Alex Miller. It is a fastball right there for strike one.
Miller so far leading the Gents this season in batting average, batting a .396 with a .492 OBP.
Having a great freshman season so far.
Absolutely.
Comes to the Gents by way of Cypress, Texas. Swung on and fouled off to the right.
Miller was also named to the National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association Division III Rookie of the Month team earlier this season, back in February.
Serves that one out into right, sinking fast, and it'll fall in front of Riley. Livesay will score easily, and it's an RBI single for Alex Miller, and the Gents lead 1-0. Miller's 15th RBI of the season. Did exactly what he needed to do there. And it's Austin Benoit, the senior right fielder. And a 1-0 count. Mallory comes set and throws to first, runners back. Swing and a miss. One and one on the Welsh native Austin Benoit. Another healthy cut, but Benoit comes up empty. One ball and two strikes. Benoit hitting .356 on the season, a homer and 19 driven in. Runner goes, pitch is swung on and missed. Throw down to second on a hop off the glove of the shortstop Woodhouse covering second. So Benoit down on strikes, but Miller steals second. And with two down, that brings up the shortstop Joby Boone.
Batting fifth, shortstop number two, Joby Boone.
First pitch swinging, snared by a diving Trapani, and he steps on the first base bag to end the inning. But the Gents pick up a run on the RBI hit by Alex Miller, As we go to the top of the second inning, it's the Gents 1, Ruse nothing. First pitch to Jake Trapani is swung on and fouled behind the plate. Nothing and one on the Ruse cleanup hitter. It's Trapani, then Asher Thompson and Brandon Hill, middle third of the Austin College lineup, due up against Cody Myers in the top of the second. 1-0 Gents lead. Here's the 0-1. Slow breaking pitch that stays too far upstairs, and the count evens at 1-1. Another breaking ball. That one catches the outer third, and it's a ball and two strikes. One, two. Foul it off. Line drive down the left field line, but it's going to get foul into the Gents bullpen. One, two. Lifted sky high, right side of the infield. It's the second baseman, Keith, who makes the call and makes the catch coming in right to the right of the pitching mound. One down. Here's Asher Thompson now, left-handed hitting third baseman. And the lefty Myers fires in a first pitch strike. The wind in the 0-1. Fastball that just misses in.
Asher Thompson coming into this one as the Ruse team leader in batting average with a 389, 421 OBP, and 528 slugging.
Grounded foul into the Ruse dugout. The 1-2. Checks his swing. And the count will even at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Myers on that one was looking for the appeal, but the first base umpire did not have a good view of that one. So no call on that one. Thompson stays alive, 2-2.
The wind and the pitch from Myers. Swing and a miss. Gauntz will throw to first to complete the K. Strikeout number 2 for Myers, and that's out number 2 in the inning. Center fielder Brandon Hill climbs in. The wind in the first pitch from Myers. Fastball stays too far outside, 1-0. Fouled off.
Hill, the team leader for the Ruse in home runs, as he has 2 on the season, 2 out of the 5 team home runs for Austin College this season. He's definitely not holding back at the plate as he is taking some big swings.
1-1, lined into right. Benoit coming in a few steps, makes the catch, and it's another 1-2-3 inning for Cody Myers. We'll go to the bottom half of the second. It's the Gents 1, Ruse nothing. First pitch fastball to Clay Menard, and it's nothing and one on the leadoff hitter for the Gents. Third baseman Clay Menard, the sophomore out of Berwick. Lefty against lefty, the 0-1. Too far upstairs, and it's 1-1. 6-7-8 in the Gents lineup due up in their half of the second. Menard, Pitts, and Gauntz. One fastball catches the outer third, and it's 1-2. Fastball called, strike 3. First strikeout of the afternoon for Mallory as he sets down Menard looking. And that'll bring up the aforementioned Colin Pitts.
Batting 7th, center fielder, number 25, Colin Pitts.
First pitch swinging, and it's over the head of the center fielder, Hill. It's going to bang up against the wall, and Pitts rounds second and heads for third. He's turning on the Jets. Here comes the throw. He's safe. A triple for Colin Pitts. And the Gents are in business with one down in the second.
Batting eighth, catcher, number 24, Jake Gons.
And Pitts really just crushed that one, didn't he?
Yeah, it's actually kind of funny. I was just about to mention Mallory for the Ruse likes to work really, really quick. And I was about to say, I think the key for success for the Gents offense today is going to be try and slow down his pace there on the mound. But first pitch swinging from Pitts, and he drove that one deep to center.
Yeah, no kidding. Gons fouls that one off. Yeah, Mallory does like to work quickly. I think he started that delivery before I was done reading Pitts' name. And that I wasn't even delayed in doing that. Sometimes I am, but that one was – he was ready to go. Gaunt's the catcher for the Gents. Bats with a runner 90 feet away from scoring. Runner breaks for the plate. I think someone missed a sign right there. Got him caught in a rundown. Trapani chases him back down. And this is going to be a real fun play to score as Pitts is eventually tagged out. Merry-go-round of a play there, and the Gents run themselves out of a potential second run. Yeah, I lost track of that one after the first baseman let go of it.
Yeah, I think that one goes down as a caught stealing 25165.
Yeah. Was that the pitcher covering home? I wasn't sure if that was the pitcher or the first baseman. I knew it was a left-hander, but.
You know, I'm not too sure. I lost track.
At least we got the replay, right?
As yes.
That one is grounded deep into the hole. It's going to be a tough play for Woodhouse. And Gaunce is able to reach first as the ball trickles away from Trapani, but not far enough for Gaunce to advance. It's an infield hit for the Gents catcher.
Batting ninth, second baseman, number 31, Miles Key.
So that'll bring up the freshman, Miles Keith. Throw over, nothing doing. Waits on the breaking pitch and sends it to pretty deep right center field, but it's the center fielder Hill who ranges to his left, makes the catch, and the inning is over. Gents had a chance to score, but it goes by the wayside. We'll go to the top of the third inning. It's the Gents 1, Ruse nothing. First pitch swinging, Mason Woodhouse lines it foul into the Gents bullpen. Nothing and one on the shortstop, Mason Woodhouse, as we begin matters here in the top of the third. Centenary with a 1-0 lead over Austin College. Game one of a doubleheader. Next pitch from Myers. Misses a little bit low. A ball and a strike. Woodhouse, Padfield, and Smith. As Woodhouse sends that one into left center, Pitts and Livesay giving chase, and it falls in between them. And sliding into second is Woodhouse. And that's how the Roos get things going in the third. Here's Ryan Padfield now. Tying run at second. Myers is going to have to buckle down here against the left fielder, Ryan Padfield. He shows bunt, and it's popped up. Gauntz makes the catch behind home. Big first out for Myers and the Gents. So here's the number nine hitter, the catcher, Greg Smith.
Gauntz on the previous play, a really good job of finding that ball straight up in the air behind them.
First pitch breaking ball just misses. Yeah, it can't be understated how difficult it is to, you know, be in the frame of mind to catch a ball and then have it be popped up, not very high in the air, throw off the mask, find the ball, and then get into position to actually make the catch.
Especially with a lot of noise going on with the crowd and dugouts. People yelling, trying to tell you where it's at. It can be tough sometimes, but Gauntz did a really good job there of tracking that one down and making the play behind the plate.
You know who could tell you a lot about what it's like to be a catcher collegiately is Nick Delonneville.
Yes, he could. I believe he's actually tuned in on this one today.
Former Gents catcher. Of course, the Gents have another former catcher on the staff, Chris Zapata, one of the finest to ever come through the system. Pitch misses outside. Myers comes set, and time is called. A violation. Myers took too long, and it's a 3-1 count now.
Seeing that rule enforced a lot now across the nation and college and the professional level.
Swing and a miss. Yeah, I didn't see it all that much, not to cut you off, but I didn't really see it that often until we got to the SCAC playoffs in Cleaver, and then they started enforcing it a little bit more, and I've seen it a lot so far this season. Rounded to short on a couple of hops. Boone handles it and throws on to first in time for out number two.
With the DH, Tino Ramirez coming up. Yeah, just before the ground out there, I was going to mention, I was watching a spring training game not long ago, and I saw three time clock violations in two innings.
Who was it?
I believe it was someone on the Dodgers. I can't remember exactly who it was. And I believe two out of the three were pitching changes, and they took too long coming out of the pen to start out the inning.
Sharp ground ball bangs off Menard. He recovers, and he's going to have to hold on to that one. Probably going to be a single too hot to handle, but we'll see. That's why they call it the hot corner, and Ruse have a couple runners aboard.
Second baseman, Tripp.
First pitch to the left fielder, Tripp Toms, who pops it up. It's the second baseman, Keith, ranging into shallow right. He makes the catch. And Myers strands a pair of Ruse on base. We'll go to the home half of the third. It's the Gents 1, Ruse nothing. First pitch to Carson Livesay, misses up and in. Gents have the top third of their lineup due up in their half of the third. Livesay walked his first plate appearance, and he swings and fouls it off to the left and out of play. Line drive into the left center field gap. That's going to get down and head toward the wall. Cut off by Padfield and left, but Livesay sliding in head first to second. He's got a leadoff double. Runner in scoring position for Lenny Forth. Livesay goes. Pitch is taken for a strike. Throw down. In time to get him. Livesay caught stealing. Play goes 2-5. And the Gents run themselves out of another potential run as Livesay cut down on the base paths. Next pitch is another strike to Forth, and it's 0-2.
Yeah, right as he took off. I was about to say he actually had a good jump, but the catcher for the Ruse did a really good job getting that one out quick.
Yeah, Greg Smith catching for the Ruse today just fired a strike right to third, and tag was applied, and that was all she wrote. 1-2. Skied to right center. Riley to his right. Makes the catch in the gap. Two down.
First baseman, Alex Miller.
So base is empty, two down, and that'll bring up the first baseman, Alex Miller. His RBI single back in the first, pushed across the game's only run thus far. And he watches the first pitch strike. Helicopter flying overhead here at Sheehy. As the next pitch is another called strike, and quickly it's nothing and two on Miller. Swing and a miss. Second strikeout for Mallory, and the inning comes to a close. We'll head to the top of the fourth. It's the Gents 1, Ruse nothing. First pitch is fouled off to the left. Nothing and one on Rayshon Riley. Three, four, five in the Ruse lineup. Riley, Trapani, and Thompson against Cody Myers. Line drive up the middle, and it's a leadoff hit for Riley. So Austin College with the runner aboard for Jake Trapani.
First baseman, Jake Trapani.
First pitch swinging, he fouls it off his foot.
Now, Pierre, before this one, we were actually talking about the last time the Ruse were here. I actually do not remember pitching to the Ruse, but apparently I pitched to Trapani here.
You did. Pitch misses outside.
It's weird how you remember certain things and not others.
Right. April 15th, 2022. Preston Ludwig getting the start for the Gents. Jake Trapani started at first for Austin College. He went 0-2 that game. Throw over. Gents won that game 5-1. That one's flied to right. Benoit drifting to his left, makes the catch. One down.
Third baseman, Asher Thompson.
Brady Robinson with a 2-run home run that game. You tripled. Welch with a pair of RBI hits.
Wow, I tripled.
Yeah. It took me till right now to realize what I just said.
You know, it's actually pretty surprising. A lot of people called me slow, but I'm up there in the triples category.
Does your name appear on the list of all-time leaders for triples in Gents history?
Not all time, but I am in the top 10.
Yeah, hey. There you go.
I'll take it.
Fouled off. Miller holding the runner. And swing and a miss by Asher Thompson. And it's no balls and two strikes on the Ruse third baseman. Throw over, runner's back. Another line drive, this time into right center field. Benoit able to cut it off. Good job by the Gents right fielder. That keeps Riley at second. But Trapani singles, and it's back-to-back hits for the Ruse to begin the fourth.
Center fielder, Brandon Hill.
Here's Brandon Hill, the center fielder. Pitch misses.
Thompson, that last at bat, did a really good job on that high pitch, keeping his hands flat, getting the bat through the zone, staying on top of it. Really good piece of hitting.
Next pitch just misses. So last weekend against University of Dallas, no bad blood between them this year, huh? No brouhaha, right?
Yeah, we don't want any brouhahas this year.
Next pitch misses, and Myers unable to find the zone, 3-0 now.
Myers done a good job in this one, going 3 1/3 without a walk, 2 strikeouts. Now was not the time to give up a free base.
3-0 fastball right down the middle for strike one.
Myers so far in the year, 27 innings pitched. Only 11 walks.
Swing and a miss.
Be a good confidence booster if he can come back after falling 3-0 to heal and getting him out.
Myers has worked hard, to get it to this point. From the stretch, here's the payoff pitch. Foul ball, and we'll do it again.
Fifty-six pitches so far in this one for Myers. 38 strikes.
Grounder to first. Miller fields and throws to second for one, and that's all they'll get as Boone puts it in his back pocket. Fielder's choice goes 3-6. Out number one in the inning and on the play. Runner takes third, so the Roos have runners at the corners.
Shortstop, Mason Woodhouse. Okay, we should come over the
middle. Here's Mason Woodhouse now. Lifted to left center, but hits in his tracks. He makes the catch, and Cody Myers again wiggles out of danger. We'll go to the home half of the fourth. It's the Gents 1, Roos nothing. Austin Benoit leading off for the Gents. Pitch misses outside, and it's 1-0. Line drive down the left field line. It's down and fair into the corner it goes. Benoit around first. He's heading for second. Padfield finally gets it in out of the left field corner. And it's a leadoff double for Austin Benoit. And the Gents have a leadoff runner in scoring position.
Austin Benoit's eighth double on the season.
Line drive up the middle, and it falls in front of Hill. Benoit to third. And back-to-back hits for the Gents put runners at the corners, nobody out for Clay Menard.
Third baseman, Clay Menard.
Benoit and Boone at the corners. Menard 0 for 1 this afternoon. He struck out his first at bat. Looking to do some damage here. Throw to first. Runners back.
Third baseman for the Ruse, Asher Thompson, playing in front of the bag, just in case the gents want to play a little small ball.
Menard can handle the bat well as he leaves that one up high.
We are starting to see a little bit of action in the Ruse bullpen. Mallory so far for the Ruse has given up 6 hits.
Swings at a high fastball and pokes it foul.
Menard in his first at bat, striking out looking, hoping to swing the bat in this one and drive in the gent's second run of this ball game.
And I imagine Thompson has a little bit more peace of mind knowing it's a left-handed hitter, Menard at the plate. It's going to be hard to have a hard line drive right at you. As count is 2-1 now on Menard.
Yeah, there were very few times when I was over at first base where I felt scared with someone at the plate. The only time I was scared is when I had a big lefty up and I was holding someone on.
Up the middle. Snared by Toms to second for one. Back to first, not in time. Gents score a run as Benoit touches home. It's 2-0 Centenary. Menard did what he needed to do, put the ball in play, and good things will happen as he picks up a run batted in on the fielder's choice.
It was actually a really good play by the second baseman for the Ruse, Toms. Really good job laying out to get that ground ball up the middle, and the glove flip to Woodhouse, able to get another out on that one.
Yeah, Toms originally penciled in as the left fielder. Late lineup change moved him to second. And so now it's Colin Pitts batting with the runner at first and one out. Quick pitched him there, and Pitts swings and misses, nothing and one.
And if you're just joining us, Pitts in his first at bat had a triple to center field in his first at bat.
Swung on and missed, throw down to second. And in time to get Menard caught stealing. Another gents runner wiped off the bases. So a clean slate for Mallory, who winds and deals the 0-2. Hit pretty high and deep, but well foul right field side. And so the count stays 0-2.
If I'm correct on this one, I believe that was Smith's second put out from behind the plate.
He's looked pretty solid back there for the Ruse today.
He's got a strong arm. He even gets rid of it quick.
1-2. Fouled behind the screen, and we'll do it again. Popped a mile high, right side. Trapani drifting, and it's the second baseman, Toms, Her range is far to his left. And in foul ground, makes a nice one-handed grab. Pitts is retired and the inning ends. But the Gents pick up another run as we go to the top of the fifth inning here at Sheehy Stadium in Shreveport. It's the Gents 2, Ruse nothing. .891 and the Ruse lineup due up as Ryan Padfield sends it right back where it came from. Myers sets his feet and throws on to first for out number one. So one pitch and one out for the Gents southpaw as Greg Smith strides to the plate. Grounded out his short his first time up. First pitch fastball in there for strike one. Next pitch misses, 1-1. Fouled off. .22 coming home from Myers. Inside, and the count runs full. Tina Ramirez waits on deck as the Ruse lineup will flip back to the top. After this next pitch to Smith, as he lines it down the left field line, it's going to get down fair. Into the corner it goes. Livesay over to retrieve it. As Smith is into second with a one-out double.
Tino Ramirez so far in this one, 1-for-2 at the plate.
First pitch swinging, he fouls it off.
P Pierre. I believe we got some fan mail. Got a recent shout out on Twitter.
I just saw that. Yep, Mike Bennett watching from his tiki hut. Thanks for the shout out, Mr. Bennett, father of Hank, Gents reliever.
We really appreciate these, the support for all the Centenary fans out there and those from Austin College tuning in today. Thank you for tuning in and watching some Gents and Ruse baseball on this beautiful Saturday afternoon.
Fires in a strike. And it's 1-2. Takes pitch low and the count evens at 2. Grounded to short. Boone on the backhand looks to second but throws to first. In time to beat Ramirez for out number 2. Breaking pitch to Toms, misses low and away. Popped right side. Miller shading his eyes, ranging into foul ground, approaching the Ruse dugout, makes the catch. And another scoreless frame posted by Cody Myers. We go to the last of the fifth. It's the Gents 2, Ruse nothing. First pitch swinging again. Jake Gauntz picks up his second hit of the afternoon. Down the right field line he goes. As Gauntz is into second base with a leadoff double.
Second baseman, Miles Keith.
So Gaunt's halfway to the cycle, single and a double. And that'll bring up the second baseman, Miles Keith.
That was Gaunt's first double on the year, actually. 18th hit on the season.
17 in singles.
Yeah.
How about that? Well, actually,
well, he has one home run.
About to say, I was like, wait a second. He could have had a, could have homered, and he did, like you said.
Gaunt's coming into this one, batting a 333 on the year. I was actually talking to assistant coach Tyler Welch, former Centenary baseball alum, before the game. We were watching the guys take BP down at field level, and you know, we see a big difference over the last week or two with some of these guys today. Their approach during BP was a lot better, seeing guys working through the middle, having a better idea of what they're going to do at the plate. And we're seeing it translate here today as Centenary now has 7 hits on the day.
Keith shows bunt and pulls back. Count moves to 1-1. Keith, a freshman out of Lindale, Texas. Runner in scoring position, nobody out. And throw down to third. Not in time, but Gaunt's coming off the bag, limping into the Gents dugout. Looks like maybe he overslid the bag and came up lame on the play, and certainly hope Gaunt is okay. You'd hate to see him. We were just talking about how hard he's worked to
Look like
improve his.
After that slide, he kind of came up limping around.
So another caught stealing for Smith. 2-1. Swing and a miss.
Yeah, there's been 4 caught stealing for the Gents today, but 3 of the 4 came from Smith behind the plate, throwing guys out.
Fastball in the outer third, and Keith goes down looking. Strikeout number 4 for Mallory.
Left fielder, Carson Libesay.
Gents lineup turns over, and it's Carson Libesay for his 3rd plate appearance. First pitch just misses. Livesey 1-for-1 with a double and a walk. 1-0. Hit sharply on a bounce to short. Handled by Woodhouse. On to first. And what looked to be a promising start to the inning ends rather abruptly for the Gents, as that'll conclude matters here in the 5th. Bottom half coming up next. It's the Gents 2, Ruse nothing.
Thank you.
Cody Myers fires in a strike to begin the bottom of the half of the fifth inning. Rayshon Riley, then Jake Trapani, and Asher Thompson, the heart of the Ruse lineup, do up to face him as Riley swings and grounds it right side of the infield. Keith able to knock it down, but not able to get a handle on it. And it's a leadoff infield hit for Riley. First pitch breaking ball finds the zone. Nothing and one on Trapani. Back to Myers. Off the mound, throw to Boone for one. Relay to first. In time to get him. Gents turn two. Myers to Boone to Miller. And just like that, two down in the inning.
Third baseman, Asher Thompson.
First pitch strike, and that double play really was just a shot in the arm that the Gents needed. I mean, you look and it's runner aboard, nobody out in the blink of an eye. Bases empty, two down. I mean, pitcher's best friend, as the next one misses, 1-1. One fastball backs Thompson off the plate. Two balls and a strike. Fastball right there for strike two. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The wind and the pitch from Myers. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Strikeout number three for Cody Myers. And the Gents get out of the inning. When we come back, it'll be the top of the sixth inning. It's the Gents two, Ruse nothing. First pitch to Lenny Forth misses. One ball and no strikes on the Gents DH. That one finds the zone and the count evens at a ball and a strike. Gents number two hitter leading off in the bottom of the sixth, to be followed by Alex Miller and Austin Benoit. Sharp line drive. Actually settled in the little seating area in the clubhouse. One of those little lofts up there, ricocheting around, and next person up there is going to find a baseball as next pitch misses. Chopper to third. In a few steps is Thompson. Off-balance throw. A little wide, but Trapani able to keep his foot on the bag for out number one.
First baseman, Alex Miller.
So fourth is a ground-out victim to begin the last of the sixth, and that'll bring up Alex Miller. Fastball misses outside for ball one. Another fastball, that one's in there, and it's 1-1. Offers at the next pitch and sends it foul off to the right. One, two, coming home to Miller. Way outside, and the count evens. Two, two. Outside, and the count runs full. Austin Benoit will hit next. He's on deck. And here's the payoff pitch from Mallory. Swung on and lifted down the right field line. Riley giving chase, and it drops foul.
Long run by Riley there, only about a foot away from the reach of his glove. I know it's talked a lot about internally here at Centenary, but playing at this field, there's a lot of ground to cover in the outfield.
And we'll see some ground covered here as Riley and Hill converge, and it's the center fielder Hill who makes the catch on the Miller fly out. Two down.
Right fielder, Austin Benoit.
We've seen so many stellar gents outfielders cover that ground over the years. Gary Hewitt, chief among those who come to mind. First pitch in there for strike one. Bryce Cosney able to cover a lot of ground.
Bryce Cosney, Caleb Ginn.
Little half swing, grounded to third. Thompson charges, throws on to first, and the gents go down in order. We'll go to the top of the seventh. It's the gents two, Ruse nothing.
for Austin College. Center fielder, Brandon Hill.
First pitch to Brandon Hill misses, and it's 1-0 on the Ruse leadoff hitter. Hill, then Mason Woodhouse, and Ryan Padfield, 6-7-8 in the Austin College lineup against Cody Myers back out there for the seventh. Gents lead 2-0 as that one's cracked into left center field, and that one's going to get out of here. Brandon Hill smokes a home run. And it cuts into the Gents' lead. It's now 2-1 Centenary. First real mistake by Cody Myers this afternoon. You know, he had to pay for it. He just hammered that pitch.
Shortstop, Mason Woodhouse.
Brandon Hill now has 3 home runs on the year, half the Ruse team total so far this season.
Myers fires in a strike to begin the at-bat to Woodhouse. And a pair of right-handers begin to loosen in the Gents' bullpen. Grounded to second, Keith on a couple of hops, on to first for out number one.
Left fielder, Ryan Padfield.
And we'll have a pinch hitter here. It's Nick Griffin to bat for Padfield. And Myers throws in a strike, and it's nothing and one. Swings through that one, and it's nothing and two. O-2 from Myers, low and inside, and it's 1-2. Weak ground ball to second, Keith charges, fields and throws on to first. So back-to-back groundouts to second have Myers one out away from getting out of the seventh. Here's the catcher, Greg Smith. Takes a pitch outside for ball one. Smith doubled earlier in this game. The wind in the 1-0. Fastball up and away, and a good hitter's count now for Smith. 2 balls and no strikes. Wind into left, but right at Livesay. And Myers permits the home run, but afterwards gets the next 3 batters down in order. Stretch time here at Sheehy Stadium. Bottom of the seventh coming up next. It's the Gents 2, Ruse 1. Joby Boone set to lead off for the Gents. The first pitch he sees is taken low for ball one. Boone, Menard, and Pitts, 5-6-7 in the Gents lineup, due up in the bottom of the seventh inning. Next pitch misses, and Boone ahead in the count, 2-0. A fastball right there for strike one. Nick Griffin, by the way, remains in the game to play left, taking over for Padfield out there. Swung on and fouled off to the right, and so the count evens up at 2-2. Up the middle. And that gets through into center field. A leadoff base hit for Joby Boone to begin the seventh.
Third baseman, Clay Menard.
Boone takes his leadoff first. And the first pitch to Clay Menard. And the hit and run was on as Boone takes second easily. Menard swinging and missing at a pitch way outside, and it got away from Smith. So the Gents with a runner in scoring position, nobody out. Menard looking to pick up another RBI. He did so earlier with the fielder's choice. Shows bunt, pulls back, and takes a pitch way up and inside for ball one.
Yeah, just before pitch one, I was thinking to myself it would be a good time to pick off, because you could tell something was on with the Gents offense, and Boone did a good job making sure that Mallory went home on the delivery.
Menard shows bunt, pulls back, and takes a pitch outside. 2-0 on the Gents third baseman, Clay Menard. Again, bunt is on, but Menard pulls the bat back and gets plunked. He gets to first the hard way, and Gents with a couple runners aboard now for Colin Pitts, as we'll have a meeting on the mound.
I think that's going to be it for Mallory.
Yeah, Preston, you're right. New pitcher coming in from the Ruse bullpen. As Mallory exits here in the seventh, allowing the first two runners to reach. Right-hander coming on for the Ruse. We'll tell you about him when we return. 2-1, the Gents lead.
Thank you. fielder, Colin Pitt.
Zach Zarnicki in relief for the Roos. His first assignment is Colin Pitts, who shows bunt, pulls back, and takes a pitch up high for ball one.
Yeah, we brought it up earlier about being scared on the hot corner.
You gotta be.
Trapani's about 30 feet away from Colin Pitts, and that's one bat you don't want to mess around with.
You really hope the slash play isn't on right now, and it's not, as Pitts, a great bunt, but Smith will allow it to roll just foul. It's the thing about this infield turf that the not a lot of friction. Those balls that are bunted down the line are just going to keep going, and oftentimes you see it like you saw right there. It'll just go foul.
One thing with Trapani coming up, though, being that close to the batter, it forces Colin Pitts to put that ball down to third base. If he doesn't, it makes it a very, very easy force out from the first baseman with a throw over to third. So if Pitts is gonna lay one down, he has to put it down the third baseline.
1-1, and Zarnicki spins and looks to second.
I'd imagine they do that just to see if Pitts pulled back there. He did not.
Pitts again squaring. Pitch, low and away. Smith lost it for a second, but retrieves it quickly, so no advancement from either runner. Boone at second, Menard at first. And Colin Pitts ahead in the count, two balls and a strike. Squaring around again. Here's the 2-1. Pulls back, and the pitch is a called strike two. Could have gone either way. Right on the black, it goes against Pitts. And the count evens at two balls and two strikes. Pitts hammers it. Deep left center. But Hill, on the warning track, makes the catch. Pitts gave that one a ride, but sent it to the deepest part of the yard. And Hill over to retrieve it. On the play, Boone advances to third, so with one down, that'll bring up what looks to be a pinch hitter for the Gents.
Looks like...
Walter Wicklund pinch hitting for the Gents. Batting for Caleb Ickes, who took over defensively for Jake Gauntz. First pitch he sees is a ball. It's 1-0. On the freshman from right here in Shreveport, Walker Wicklund, graduate of Captain Shreve High. Swings and sends it to left center. As Hill's over to make the catch, Boone will score easily, and it's a sacrifice fly for Walker Wicklund, and the Gents lead 3-1. Keith, first pitch swinging, another fly ball to center. And Hill, to his left, makes the catch. And that'll end the inning. But the Gents pick up a run on the Walker Wicklund sack fly as we go to the top of the eighth inning. It's the Gents 3, Roos 1.
the Gents. Now catching, number 28, Aiden Steele. Getting off for Austin Collins. He's an 8 Team of the
First pitch from Cody Myers in the eighth is outside for ball one. A couple of defensive changes for the Gents. We'll get to that in a second. As the next pitch to Ramirez is swung on and missed. One ball and one strike. New catcher for Myers is Aiden Steele. And Braden Morris takes over at second. Next pitch misses outside. Two balls and a strike. Top third of the Ruse lineup due up in their half of the eighth. Ramirez, then Toms and Riley. Fouled back to the screen, and the count evens at two.
Yeah, up here in the bottom of the seventh, Walker Wicklund came up for the Gents. That sac fly, and only his 15th at bat of the season. Picks up his second ribby on the season. Really good job of coming in and doing the job.
Local product, Walker Wicklund, shown some good fundamental baseball.
I believe he was a Captain Shreve graduate.
That's right. Of course, one of the greatest Gents in the D3 era came from Captain Shreve. That's Michael Schimpf. Played 4 years here for the Gents from 2013 to 17, part of that 2017 championship team. Payoff pitch from Myers is popped foul. And the payoff pitch misses just low. Could have been a strike, but wasn't. And Myers issues the leadoff walk to Ramirez. And that'll bring up Tripp Toms.
Second baseman, Tripp Toms.
Miller holding the runner at first. First pitch from Myers is swung on and it gets away from Steele. That'll allow Ramirez to take second. It'll be a passed ball on Steele. That one finds the zone. Nothing and two now on Toms. Gents lead 3-1. Grounded to third, Menard. Throws on to first. Miller's relay back to third, not in time to get him. So Toms grounds out for out number one. And on the play, Ramirez takes third. And with one down now, that'll prompt a visit from Mike Diaz. We'll see if that's it for Cody Myers. Action has been loosening in the Gents bullpen for some time now.
Yeah, Myers is at 103 pitches already in this one, and just a 7 1/3 innings of work. The walk to Ramirez, his first walk on the day. Only 3 strikeouts, 1 earned run. He's done a good job here in this one. Obviously, the hit column for the Ruse is high with 7, but Cody Myers has done a good job limiting the damage with that and getting guys out when he needed to.
And Diaz is going to stick with his man. So here's Rayshon Riley.
Riley 2 for 3 in this one.
Way out in front of that one as he drives it well foul. 0-1 on the Ruse number 3 hitter, Rayshon Riley. Pair of singles on his ledger this afternoon. Ramirez leading off third, the 0-1, out to left, Livesay, and knocks it down but comes up empty. Ramirez scores, and it's a one-run ball game. As the Ruse plate their second run, it's 3-2 Gents now, and that will be the end of the line for Cody Myers. Gents will have a new pitcher when we return. They lead it 3-2 in the eighth.
Thank you.
New pitcher on for the Gents is Jacob Broussard. First pitch breaking ball in there for strike one. So Myers exits with one out in the eighth. He goes 7 1/3 innings, strikes out three, allows just the two runs. Swing and a miss. So it was a tale of two ball games. Myers last time out, strikeout 13. Today, just three, but essentially the same result. Both very solid outings for the Gents left-hander. Broussard comes set, throws to first, nothing doing. Jake Trapani at the plate for the Ruse. Broussard, a sophomore out of Houston, 0-4 record this season with a 6.55 ERA. A solid freshman campaign back in 2023, as that one's fouled off. Riley aboard at first. That last play rolled an E7. As Trapani fouls it off. Stretch. Here's the 0-2 from Broussard. Softly hit into center. Pitts charging. He makes the catch. Big second out for the Gents. Two down for Asher Thompson. Throw to first. Runner's back. Swing and a miss. Nothing and one on the left-handed hitting Ruse third baseman. Next pitch from Broussard. Chopped behind the plate. Time is called. Runner goes. Here's the 0-2. Called a ball, throw down, and it'll be a stolen base for Riley. Count moves to 1-2. And the tying run in the scoring position for the Ruse. Broussard comes set. Now comes home. Fastball didn't get a call on the inside edge. Gents dugout and the home fans alike wanted that one but didn't get it.
I know that call doesn't go your way, but as a pitcher, you got to be mentally tough and get back in there and make your pitch right here.
2-2 breaking ball stays too far inside, and count runs full. Brandon Hill waits on deck. Should the inning continue, he'd hit next. Broussard looking to end the inning right here. The Gents right-hander comes set. Here's the payoff pitch. Lifted to center. Pitts in and to his right, makes the catch. And that'll end the inning. So Jacob Broussard comes in and retires both batters he faces. As we head to the home half of the eighth inning, it's the Gents 3, Ruse 2. Gents looking for some insurance as we begin the home half of the eighth. Top third of the Centenary lineup due up to face Zarnicki, who spins a first pitch curveball in there for strike one. Next pitch just off the outside black, and it's 1-1. Fastball right there, and it's 1-2. Swing and a miss. So Livesay down on strikes. First K for Zarnicki. And that'll bring up the DH, Lenny Forth.
Designated hitter, Lenny Forth.
Lenny Forth looking to turn around his day as he's 0-3 in this one.
Zarnicki fires in a fastball, and it's 1-1. Bounces in the dirt. Two balls and a strike. Fastball in the outer third, called strike two. Two to fourth. And off his forearm there. So fourth hit by the pitch. Gents will have a runner at first with one down for Alex Miller.
It looks like we're going to have a pinch runner for Lenny. Looks to be number 54, Andrew Landry.
For the Gents, number 54, Andrew Landry will run at first base. First baseman, Alex Miller.
So Landry, the runner at first. Some more speed on the bases. And it's Alex Miller to bat. Swings at the first pitch and fouls it behind the plate. Landry goes, pitch is taken high. Throw down from Smith, not going to get him. So Landry picks up the stolen base, and the Gents have a runner in scoring position, just the one out, and a 1-1 count on Miller.
That'll be Landry's second stolen base on the year. So he is now 2-for-3 on stolen bases.
Miller sends that high in the air, deep to left, but approaching the track and reaching up to make the grab is Griffin. Landry tags and slides in safely at third. So good base running there by Landry. Miller gave that one a ride, but just short of the wall. And with two down, that'll bring up Austin Benoit.
Right fielder, Austin Benoit. First
pitch, fastball in there for strike one. A healthy lead down there at third for Landry. That fastball just misses outside.
Zarnicki working out of the windup. Landry's taking full advantage of that, getting as much ground towards home plate as he can.
One, one. Line to center. Drifting back, though, is Hill. He makes the catch just shy of the track, and the Gents strand a runner at third. Not a lot of wiggle room for the Gents as we head to the top of the ninth inning. It's the Gents 3, Ruse 2.
Thank you. for Austin Collins. Center fielder, Brandon Hill.
Six, seven, eight in the Ruse lineup. Last chance for Austin College. They're down by a run as the Gents lead 3-2. Jacob Broussard back out there for the ninth, and he spins a curveball in there. Or I beg your pardon, it just missed. One ball and no strikes. The 1-0. Misses low and away, and it's two balls and no strikes on Brandon Hill. Mason Woodhouse on deck, and Nick Griffin in the hole. .20 fastball in there, and it's 2-1 now.
I was actually talking to head coach Mike Diaz for the Gents before this one, and we were talking about Jacob Broussard and his numbers on the year and how they don't really reflect the way that he's actually performed on the field.
Line drive up the middle, and so that's how the ninth gets underway for the Ruse. It's a leadoff hit for Hill, and the tying run over at first base now for Austin College.
Yeah, just before that base hit by Hill, was talking about Broussard, and we're talking about how, you know, his 6 ERA on the year doesn't really reflect how you do.
As that one's out to right, but Benoit charging in a throw to first. It gets past Miller, and perhaps an unwise decision there as that will allow the runner to take second. Hill advances 90 feet, and that puts the tying run in scoring position, and it looks like he's going to be awarded third base as the ball got out of play. So really tough E9 for the Gents to take there.
But now, Pierre, I mean, this is kind of the topic I was just talking about. That right there is kind of a demonstration as to, you know, what just kind of defines Broussard's year is he's been put in these tough situations, and, you know, a simple error right there. Now you have a runner on third with one out instead of a runner on first with one out. And that right there can be the difference between this game being tied after this inning or potential loss for the Gents.
So it's Scott Hosmer to grab a bat and pinch hit for the Ruse with the tying run at third and one out. First pitch from Broussard, misses outside, ball one. Hosmer batting for Nick Griffin. Gents infield playing in for a play at the plate, trying to cut off the tying run. Here's the 1-0. Back to Broussard, he stabs it, looks to third, and throws on to first, a huge second out for the Gents. That's why they practice those PFPs. Broussard made it look easy, and the Gents are one out away now from winning.
Catcher Greg Smith.
And the guy who stands in between the Gents and the win is a guy who's been a thorn in their side all afternoon, the catcher Greg Smith. First pitch misses, it's 1-0. Broussard's 1-0. In the air to right. Benoit underneath it. He makes the catch. And that's a Diamond Gent winner in game one of today's doubleheader. 3-2, the final score. And it was pretty tedious toward the end, but Jacob Bruce aren't able to buckle down. And the Gents claim game one today. Cody Myers will get the win. Jacob Broussard picking up the save, and we got another ball game just around the corner. Game two coming up soon. We'll give you the final totals from game one when we return from Sheehy Stadium here in Shreveport. Gents win this one 3-2, and here are all the final totals for the Gents, who improved to 7-9 overall, 2-1 in the Southern Collegiate Athletic Conference. 3 runs on 8 hits with 2 errors. The Ruse, 2 runs on 8 hits with no errors. So both teams had 8 hits, but the Gents come out on top by a run. Ruse, by the way, fall to 7-10 overall, 1-2 in conference play. The winning pitcher is Cody Myers. He improves to 5-1 on the season. Jacob Broussard picks up his second save, and Tristan Mallory assessed the loss. He falls to 1-3. Time of the game was 2 hours and 20 minutes. In front of a nice crowd here in game one, 184 the estimate. And we got more baseball coming your way next in about 20 to 30 minutes. Game two between the Austin College Ruse and the Centenary Gents. Hope to see you around for that one. But Preston, any final thoughts for what you saw here in the opener today?
I think the pitching was a lot better than what we've seen so far this season. Myers, really, really good job on the mound. Threw a lot of strikes, got ahead early. I think he only fell behind in only a handful of at-bats, but did a really good job really commanding the zone and getting guys to give up weak contact. Good job by Broussard coming in and limiting the damage with the situation that he was put in. So good job by him. And the offense really seemed to turn it around today. I know only hit eight hits, still a good number. But I saw approaches so far in game one were a lot better than what I've seen in the previous couple of weeks. And I think these guys are starting to finally find their identity at the plate. and having good approaches. So good job by them. We'll see if they can continue that in game two.
Yeah, that's back-to-back good outings, outstanding outings, really, by Cody Myers, the sophomore left-hander for the Gents. And yeah, we talked about it at the beginning of the broadcast, Gents having to get the ball going, and that was a big first step, taking game one today by a final of 3-2. Still another game left to play today before the finale tomorrow afternoon, but we'll see you in a little bit. For Preston Ludwig, my name's Pierre Bida, signing off for the next 20 minutes or so. Hope to see you again for game two, Ruse and Gents, coming up shortly from Sheehy Stadium here in Shreveport, Louisiana.